Welcome to Appenzell. My name is Hans Fritschi and this is Dominik Landwehr, my good friend.
Hello.
Why did you take me to Appenzell today? What's the idea?
Well, you have not been to Switzerland for a long time and I wanted to show you just a very nice, wonderful little spot in a remote place. And I thought that you also like the beer, so therefore we went to the local brewery.
Ah, good thought. Okay, let's go and have a look around in Appenzell. Welcome to scenic Appenzell. This is an old place in the mountains of Appenzell. This is a part of Switzerland and we just came here to visit this scenic place. You see my friend Dominik Landwehr. He is my driver and we are enjoying ourselves in Appenzell. You know, they have here very nice houses. You cannot imagine how beautiful these are here. Look at this facade of this old house. It's a Bazar Hirsche. It's probably an old hotel Hirsche. And here the old Schindelhäuser. They have a facade made out of little pieces of wood.
This is a specialty, famous specialty of this local coffee shop. It's called Cheese Feet of Appenzell, but you better translate it as Stinky Feet from Appenzell. In fact, it's a little piece of dough baked in the oven with some cheese, which gives a characteristic smell. And some people say Stinky Feet are Cheese Feet. So, Cheese Feet from Appenzell, enjoy. Delicious, lovely.
We are still in Appenzell. It's very interesting here. You know, on the way here, we went to Schaukäserei. That's a place where they show you how to make milk. And you can see these guys here. They have the usual local habit of Appenzell and they produce a lot of milk here. If you look at the landscape, this is a place that cows love. They eat the grass up in the mountains and then it is turned into cheese, delicious cheese. Appenzeller cheese is one of the very famous cheeses. You know, these are typical guys from here. They also have an earring. This is a very typical thing here. The old fellows, they wear earrings and they are not homosexuals or anything. This is just traditional, you know, the traditional uniform. And funny guys, these are the Appenzell. This is the typical Appenzell landscape. You see, you have this relatively mellow hills with some trees and some forests, and there are animals grazing here. You see the sheep, and more importantly, there are many cows. But have a look at this landscape. It's full of fresh green grass, you know, that the cows, the sheep, the horses can eat and graze off. And this is a very fertile area right now, but soon the winter is coming and the cows that went up to the mountains for grazing during summer have left the higher locations already, because soon the snow will fall and then the cows are fed with the dried grass. You know, this is cut down and carefully dried, that the poor cows don't have to starve in winter. That's, you know, we have been to the chocolate museum. There the cows are important because they deliver the good milk that is put into the famous Swiss chocolate. And here we see the landscape of Appenzell, where the grass grows that feeds the cows or the sheep and delivers the many goodies that we know from Switzerland. You see those wonderful, wonderful cows, and not the dog is the best friend of man. It's the cow, of course, because they give us milk. We can make cheese, as we have seen in the city of Appenzell, and we can eat them up as in sausages, as steaks, just wonderful. But last but not least, those wonderful animals, they shit a lot. And I, as a gardener, can tell you, this is really a beneficial thing what they drop all over. Here you have the typical souvenirs of Appenzell. You know, you see also in a very old, nice building, you have the Spazierstöcke and you know, the walking sticks. They are all made from local woods, and they look funny. You have the modern ones here in the back part, and the traditional ones over here. And then you have the different cowbells. And the cows normally wear bells here in Switzerland, so you can always hear where they are. And then you have the fondue pots, the gaglons, in any shape and size. And here you have the bells, the belts with all these cow motifs on them. You see the cows and the Appenzeller. And here you have eine Armbrust. You remember William Tell, when he shot the apple from the head of his son, he used one of those. Well, these are nice souvenirs that we could take back to Thailand, but since we don't know when we can come back, I have decided I don't want to stay 14 days in quarantine, and I wait till that nonsense stops, and I might go in winter when it's getting cold here in Appenzell, or in Switzerland in general. Maybe I go to Brazil or some warm place, maybe Florida, and till we can go back to Thailand under reasonable conditions.
Tobacco pipe, very typical for this canton of Appenzell. The tobacco pipe is not only used by adult men, but to the dismay of many visitors from abroad, it's also used by small boys at the occasion of the opening of the Alp, or even more when they come down from the Alp, which is called the Alp Abzug. So everybody is having his most interesting local folk dress, and the kids and the boys particularly are smoking the typical tobacco pipe. So that's the pipe you see here.
Look, we have discovered a very nice feature here, the dwarfs of Appenzell. You know, they are the small little dwarfs, and they are made from, you know, they are plastic, these ones. So, but the other ones, they are made from some stone. And here you have one that blows the Alp horn. This used to be a communication device where people from different Alps could communicate with each other. And of course you can buy them. Oh, he has stunning blue eyes, this dwarf. Huh? Very nice one. And there are smaller ones. There are bigger ones. Look at this. This one is a really large one. He plays some instrument. This one seems to be a bit angry, huh? Might be a student and not happy with the government. And lovely, lovely dwarfs, the dwarfs of Appenzell. Ah, here you have some hunters. It's a hunting season, as you know, and we can eat some venison all the time. And this is a lady that likes the man. And dwarfs of Appenzell, I guess we don't want to stay overnight. There's an elegant dog. Oops. Very nice, a dog in front of the Hotel Hech. Fifi. No, he doesn't listen to me. And he's very. Wie heißt er? Bonita. The hot dog is called Bonita. Yeah, die Bonita. Hallo, Bonita. Hallo. Hübscher Hund. Ah, sie gehört nicht mehr. Oh, the dog cannot hear anymore. Very sad story to report from Hotel Hecht in front of Hotel Hecht that Bonita cannot hear anymore. Tragedy in Appenzell. Dominic, thanks again for a worthwhile excursion to Appenzell. In the background you see the local brewery where they make a highly successful beer, and I have tried it for a little zwiri or late lunch, and you had one without alcohol, right? You are the driver.
Exactly, I had one without alcohol, and they all have very funny names.
Yes, and if you liked what you saw today from Appenzell, please join the Hans Fritschi channel on YouTube or Hans Fritschi Friends on Facebook, and see you again very, very soon.
See you again. Have a nice time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.